Hey everyone, it's Glitchy1000, welcome back to my Let's Play of Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. Last time we left off, we finished a Lanayru mining facility, and now we are told by, I think it might have been Zelda, that we need to head to the Sealed Grounds. What's that damn bird again? No, it was Impa, that we needed to return to the Sealed Grounds to speak with the old lady. So we're gonna need to go back to the sky anyway, so we've got a bunch of rupees we want to sell and a bunch of other stuff I want to do too. So this might be like an interval sky, sky around Skyloft. Hope try and get some side quests in there too. We also need to go to the Sealed Grounds as well. I do want to go to the Sealed Grounds before finishing this episode, so let's quickly head to Skyloft real quick. Okay, so we'll quickly go to the bazaar. I do want to fix my shield, so I'll get that one done. I got like 600 rupees. I should be able to get some stuff. Yeah, fix the shield first. You're right here. Get that one done real quick. Pretty sure you're like 10 rupees to fix. Yeah. And then we'll see what gear we can upgrade. We've got a fair bit of items too, so we can upgrade the beetle, I know that. Oh, hornet larvae. I do not have any of those. I don't have dusk relics. No evil crystals. I do have all the stuff for the best shield, but I already got it upgraded, so what about a steel one? I do have that one. Might go for a better one. Monster Claw, not quite. What about Bomb? Ooh, I can do this one too. What's this one? So, do I want an Iron Shield or like a bigger Bomb Bag? Because I only have 3 Ornament Skulls. Let me get one of these. Actually, let's quickly check the shop real quick. See if there's anything new. Yeah, there's nothing new. I'm pretty decent with a shield. So I'll go upgrade my bomb bag. So if I... I'll probably regret it later on when my iron shield breaks. It doesn't look like there's any new quests. Ooh, do you have like something? Hey, there's something that I'll put some fire into Billy Young Mean. The new potion. Oh yeah. Stamina potion. He says a bit pricey. That's a bit of a tough sell for me. Anything pricey is a bit of a tough sell. I don't have any more pouches. And I'm pretty sure the next pouch is like not 600 rupees. From what I remember. Let's see what Beetle's got. If Beetle doesn't got anything, then it'll just be a shame on Beetle. Alright, how much is that pouch? Ooh, 600 rupees. What the? Okay, so you didn't stock up from that one. Yeah, I'll take that 600. I do have enough. Maybe I should have gotten that, that chest that I missed in the previous dungeon. So, what does Fee say? Objective. We need to go to the Sealed Grounds. Yeah, all cool. It doesn't look like I have anything left to do here. Although I kind of want to start some side quests, because I think now would be a good time. But I don't see any has activated yet. Or any that is on. Maybe I might check the Knights Academy. I know there's a goddess chest there, but I can't get to it as now. I'll quickly go to Knight's Academy. If there's nothing there, I'm just gonna cut straight to the Sealed Grounds. Okay, so I lied about going to the Sealed Grounds right after checking the Knight's Academy, but I am gonna get some goddess chests on the way here, but I do see something I want that I haven't gotten in a while. Not gotten a while, that I've been considering getting. Wait, which one is it? This one. His face. Why would you do that? Get down here and come here, assistant. Oh, hey, you're, oh no, you've done and gone made a terrible mess, haven't you? Well, now you're gonna go be in the world of trouble. Can I at least get my heart container? Alright, I'm just gonna grab my loot here. Just gonna grab everything. Look, I'm sorry, see, you don't get paid enough for this. Don't even pretend that was an accident. I put signs there to warn people to be careful of the chandelier and everything. While I wash my hands of the whole thing, don't be surprised if my dad gives you a royal chewing out. I wonder what happens if we just, like, you know, try to leave. Hey now, you don't think you can come in here and break my chandelier and just get away with it, do you? Oh, so that's why you only have one door, okay. Oh, poor dude, you alright? You didn't have food there. Oh no, you've done it now. There's no escaping this one. I mean, I don't see the problem. I already got my piece of heart. What were you thinking? You scared the year out of my life. What do you want again? I lost my train of thought. What, are you telling me you moved the gravestone? Oh yeah, that, I forgot about this one. And did you see the monster? What, you weren't scared? You can't fool me. I bet you're scared stiff. Well, I mean, I'm scared that I don't know what this man's gonna do to me now. What is wrong with you? Just look at what you've done. You broke my fancy custom-ordered chandelier. Well, I mean, I think it's too fancy for your restaurant. Apologize. Restaurant bar? I don't know what it is. You're going to have to be working for me for free until you pay off every single rupee that chandelier cost me. Got it? Pretty sure that was like 6 rupees. Yeah, sure. I got time. I'm gonna hold you to that. Let's not waste any time putting you to work. I need you to deliver my famous soup to Aegis Skyloft's Knight Commander. The Knight Commander is a regular here. He says he can't get its day started without a bowl of my soup. What do you say? You ready for deliver some soup? We'll do one delivery. I don't know how, you haven't got an empty bottle. Oh, well, I don't have an empty bottle. I don't want to use it. Or do I? No, I don't want to. Oh no, I'll do it, I'll do it. Alright. Link? Let's do it. Let's do it quickly. Do it to that Knight Commander. 5 minutes! Where is he? The Knight Commander hates cold soup. I'm sure anyone hates cold soup, and I'm pretty sure microwaves weren't a thing in this time. So you're going to take this over to him. Where is he? Less than 5 minutes or the soup will get cold. Yeah, but where is he? Well, at least tell me where he is. At least on the map. Is he not going to tell me where the... Now, where exactly do we go? Hop! Oh, that's already time off it. This will pause it, right? Pause the 5-10 minutes. Oh, pumpkin soup. I'll just go to Skyloft. Where is Skyloft? This way. Now, which one is the Knight Commander? Knight Commander? Oh, maybe it's this guy. I'm just gonna check here because there's pretty sure there's like one here. It might actually be Pooman. No, it is Pooman. Pooman? Your name's Pooman. I'm gonna hope you're Pooman. No, Pooman's the other guy. You're the one I'm supposed to be. Aegis. There we go. I did get it right first time. I definitely did do this quest. That's right. Sorry. Nah. Here you go. So good. That's the stuff. Pumpkin soup is best piping hot. Well done, thanks to the owner for me. Okay, let's quickly get out of here. I'm actually gonna go and get this goddess chest real quick, because I did already mark all the goddess chests, so I can get them on the way. There's one right here. What kind of floating island is that, though? Oh, yeah, no. Okay. I'll just do down view. Land link. There we go. And we got the 1-2. What are we getting? Heart metal. Wait, did that already go through my pouch? I mean, I do go through a lot of hearts, so that is a good thing. But at the same time, I kind of want to save that extra space in any case. Okay, let's go straight to the pumpkin landing. And then we can get to the other two chests. Let's see if we can aim this from here. Ooh, wait, what are those? Where's the other one? Ah, oh, damn it. I never get those successfully done. I can never get them. Is this like another doorway? Where does this one lead to? Oh, just the back door, okay. Oh, looks like you are able to deliver the soup to Iga safely. Oh, your name's Poom. I got the names mixed up. I'll subtract your wages from the bill for Chandelier. And if you think we're even, better think again. Next, I need you to help harvest the pumpkins. And I'm not even talking for no for an answer. Well, why did you waste your time? Don't even feel bad what you did. Well, I had one delivery done, but I do have things to do. At least save me for one delivery. Jeez, man. Jeez, Poom. I'll do the pumpkin delivery later. Pretty sure you're here for... Yeah, I assume you're here for the pumpkin deliver. Pumpkin... Wait. Pretty sure this one's a really hard one that I struggled with. It was like a lot of balancing. So let's quickly get those chests and we can head straight to the sealed grounds. Alright, this one's an easy one. What is it gonna be? Ooh, silver rupee. Perfect. We do need that money again. Now let's go quickly get the other one. Oh, what kind of island is this one? It's a bit unusual. Come on, Link. Oh, is it the other side? Yeah, it's the other side. Ooh, piece of heart. Nice. We do need that. We've got two more before we can get another full heart container. And now let's go to make our way to Farron Woods. We're finding out what the heck this one is. What is this? Out of work for today. Oh, it's Beetle's Island. And there's also a little way for him to get out. Okay. Oh, speaking of Beetle's Island. Oh, it mobilizes them too. Okay, that's something new. It's also good to get some beetles. If there's like more insects here, then this would be like a good place to get some insects. Let's quickly head to Farron Woods now. Come on, Link, you can just make it. Make it. Come on. There we go. In the middle you go. That'll work, right? There we go. I was like wondering, wait, was I too high when I did that? No, it works. Link's heading to the sealed grounds now. Oh! I forgot about this scene. Link, help! I completely forgot about this scene. That's awesome. Ugh, rough landing. Grease really did follow Link. I thought he was still stuck in his room. Hey, I think I might have broke something. Hey, seriously, did anyone ever teach you how to land found crap. Whoa! Tiny birds? The birds? Tiny birds. What are they? Tiny birds. Groose, they're tiny birds. And what is that thing? Oh, he's never seen a Goron before. Poor Groose. He's upset that he found someone stronger looking than him. But how? Where am I? This is why Groose is so iconic. Well, I mean, the first scene was iconic, but Groose is just... What's going on here? Ever since Zelda vanished, you've been zipping in and out of town in a hurry. So I figured I'd tell you and might it lead me to Zelda. But this is so wild. Seriously, what is that thing over there? That's a Goron, Groose. I told you the second time. And what's with all these trees? There are so many. Oh, yeah, there wasn't many trees in Skyloft. Just give me a straight. I can take it. Where are we? Where is Zelda here? What's the deal with this place? If there's something... If there's supposed to be nothing below the crowds, then what's all this? You're dead, Groose. You died falling out of nothing. This is purgatory. Heaven or hell, whatever you put it in. Link's just like, it's okay, mate. I don't know what it is either. Well, here's the thing. While you were upset about Zelda going missing, I went here and saved the world. He's just like... Whoa. All the birds really are clinging onto him. You're kind of implanting my mind right now, but I think I get what you're saying. If I've got this right, Zelda's down somewhere here and she's okay. Well, she's not dead. She's okay. Oh, wow. That's so great. Hearing that is such a huge weight of my... Hearing that... is such a huge weight off my mind. I wish birds cling to me like that. Although I probably just run away the moment they come near me. But you know, Link, it's sort of alright down here. This place needs a name. Oh. Yeah, a name fitting for this rugged, adventurous wilderness. From now on, we'll call it GROOSELAND. Of course. Link's just like, huh? Nanny? So let me see if I got this right. The old lady living in the temple down the road from here knows where Zelda is. I see. Right, Link. Thanks for getting me here. You've done a good job. You can let head home. No, Groose, I'm coming with you. Big Groose will handle the search for Zelda from here. Yep, I'll track her down, save her, and then give her a lift back to Skyloft. First off, how are you going to get out? And then when we get back, I'll ask her if she wants to make our whole going out thing official. And then the two of us can get some quality time together. Groose, were you ever official to begin with? No, it wasn't official. He said it wasn't official. He's in his own wonderland. Anyway, the point is your work here is done. I've got it covered from here. You don't know crap, Groose. I was the one who had to fight off tiny scorpions with one eye and a giant scorpion with three eyes. So I think I've got this one covered. By the way, I'm the one with the sword. Just saying. Now it's off to find that old lady you were talking about. Catch you later, Link. Does he know where he's going? I'd be surprised if he did. Oh crap, I was supposed to grab those feathers. Oh, there's Gorko. He wants something, but I also want something here too. Actually. Oh, Link. Woodland Rhino Beetle. Oh, I haven't got this one yet? Well, I do now. Alright, Gorko. Hey bud, we meet again. In hurry as usual, yeah? Yep, I've been keeping busy too, checking out the wonders of the world. Say, you want to hear about some of my research? Yeah. Okay, but prepare to be amazed. I made a huge discovery while I was out doing my field research. So I get a load of this. Apparently there are walls and statues respond to the beautiful tones. Wild, right? You want to know more? Yeah. All right, that's the kind of archaeological enthusiasm I like to believe. Oh, but before we go into fascinating details of walls and statues, there's something I better ask you about, bud. You ever heard of the blessed butterfly? I have seen them. I think I do know about them. All right, bud, then let me jump straight to the point. Ancient tomes mentioned these butterflies flapping around packs by certain walls and statues. Seems like these butterflies have some kind of sixth sense they are detecting. Something you want to hear more? Which are you interested in? Walls. From what I've learned, it sounds like these walls are left behind the goddess for the hero mentioned in legends. The things of the hero desire are said to spring forth from the beyond the cloud, beyond the walls. That is why they call them the goddess walls, I suppose. Hungry to hear more? Yeah, we can do more reading. That's the spirit, but sadly, that is far as my research has gotten me. As soon as I make new discoveries, you'll be the first to know. That's good to know. Pretty sure you had to do something with the sword that involved it. I don't know. Oh, there's more. Beautiful. Yeah, let's go up here. Okay. Oh, this is like another route. Hey, why was it pointing that way? Oh no, that is Silgrand's. Why was that one there? I don't know. Alright, let's go ahead and make sure Groose doesn't do anything stupid. Actually, I wouldn't be surprised if Groose did found it, because it's just a linear path. What? You gotta be kidding me, Granny! Don't talk to her like that. You're messing with me. Say it again. I dare you. I only speak the truth. You are not the one who will save her. The spirit maiden, your Zelda, can only be saved by another. It has to be his. It has been his fate to do this thing, and in doing so, save us. As it was decided long before you brought crying into world. shut it, Granny. You obviously don't know me well, because if you did, you'd know if that's anyone's gonna save Zelda, it's gotta be Groose. How could it not be me? Plus, if it ain't me, why would it be even be here? If I'm not up to the job of being the hero, just who is? Me, bitch. I'm the one with the sword. The talking sword. Oh, now I get ya. Link, Granny here has been trying to tell me you're gonna be the big hero who's rescues Zelda. Well, to be fair, I don't think Groose has a reincarnation in any other game. I don't think. Unless he's meant to be a goose, I don't know. What a joke. Look what I've heard so far. A bunch of babbling about destiny. But that's a load of garbage. I know you and you're no hero, shrimp. You right there, man? Greetings, Link. Were you able to catch up with Zelda? Ah, I see. So the Guardian was there as well, was she? The one you saw by Zelda's side is known as Impa. She is being sent forth by the goddess to aid Zelda in her quest. The two have traveled somewhere in order to accomplish the great task Destiny has set before them. However, now that Impa has destroyed the gate that they use, there is only one way left to find them. You must take use of the harp given to you by Zelda. Tell me, Link, have you attempted to play the harp you received? My sense is that you have not yet familiarized yourself with. Very well, I shall teach you how to play it. Listen well and do as I say. First, press X to ready your harp. Oh, that's right, I hated this part. Okay. It's not that I don't have rhythm, it's just... Good. Now for your next lesson, focus and play in time with the pulsing of the circle of light. When the timing is right, I shall join my voice to your harp. Listen well, for the song I sing will be the great help to you in your journey. I saw Chester, can I? Oh, I guess not. Yeah, I gotta go slowly or fast? Link is not good at playing the harp, by the way. You don't just strum it like going, what do you call it? The thing on a piano where they just go all notes with like one hand, like sliding it there. That's not how you play the harp. I'm sorry. I'm no harp expert. I just have seen people play harps. Kind of bothers me. And it doesn't even sound nice either. I'm glad they stick to that. You've learnt the Ballad of the Goddess, the mysterious melody that has been passed down from ancient times. What, by a child? No, that doesn't sound good. The singing does, but not the harp. Well, not how Link was playing it, anyways. Ooh, fancy. The harp you hold is known as the Goddess's Harp. Is a divine instrument of the goddess who once watched over this land. The melodies it brings to life have the power to produce a variety of strange and otherworldly effects. The great slab standing before you is known as the Gate of Time. It is the last of its kind in existence, the only portal binding our world to the one where Zelda now resides. If you manage to open the gate and pass through, you will likely end up in the same place as Zelda. But you'll need to endure many hardships and put yourself in great danger to awaken the gate from its dormant state. Though your journey will put you in a harm's way, Link, you must endure. It is your fate as the chosen hero of the god. Oh, damn it, Grease, what did you do this time? This shaking, I feel the seal has been broken. I expect this would react to your summoning to the gate, but I never imagined a seal would break so quickly. Link, there will be time to explain later. Right now, you must hurry to the bottom of the pit outside. Damn it, Grease. Wait, right now? Just wait, I saw a chest here I want to get. Don't stop me, old lady. Chest come first. Ooh! Ooh! Damn it! Okay, looks like I have to go back to Skyloft. Can I save later, must go. I'll probably regret it later. Grease, what did you do this time? Oh, wait, I remember. Grease is right there. What's with all the shaking? See, I'm gonna prove to Grease that I'm the hero. This whole ground is heavy heaving. I thought it was supposed to be solid down here. That here is called an earthquake. Go quickly, Link. Check on the ceiling spike at the center of the pit. There is nothing... Pardon me? There was nothing natural about these tremors. That monster could free itself at any moment. Approach the pit with caution. Okay. Oh, hell no. It's that monster's ink looking thing. Okay, that kind of made me uncomfortable. Probably because I'm up close watching it, the imprisoned. Now, I do remember your toes are sensitive. I knew it, the seal has given way. I'll explain later, but now it's time for action. We must keep that beast from escaping that pit. It must not reach the temple. It's just 1 foot, right? Yeah, I think it's just 1 foot. Or 2 foot. Oh, it has to be both feet. Yeah, I remember how to do this one. This one's not too bad. I think... Yeah, this one's not too bad. Look, quickly get this one. Oh. There we go. Oh, we can. This might be a bit too... Yeah. I'm gonna quickly dive. Wait, doesn't Link still fall like this? And his toes grow again. Ha! No! No! Oh, now I just went back to the bottom. That's not cool. Or at least he's right there. He was going faster though. Oh, he's using this one. Oh, he's gonna attack at that one now. Again. Where am I? Oh. I don't know what happened there. I think I was just in a... in a weird spot. And I believe there's one more phase. Or one more turn. Where's the nearest draft here? Yeah, that should be... You gonna stop? Oh, damn it, he's not gonna stop. Oh, he stopped now. This one's not too bad. I thought it was gonna be like until the end of the episode. I think we can do a little bit more after this. Because most of the... Oh, now he's going faster. Ooh, almost got hit from that one. Where am I? Link, go quick. Okay, that sounds like it's gonna be the end. I'm just looking at it. There's a lot of scales and very sharp teeth. That's very... This is just a very pokey boss. A pokey monster. It just looks like... Like, as soon as you touch it, you're... It's like... It's sort of like touching a cactus. Like a really... No, would it be like touching a cactus or like a bunch of knives at once? But then if you touch a bunch of knives at once... It wouldn't hurt as much, would it? Unless like they're super, super sharp, then it's probably gonna... I don't know, he just looks very sharp. Now Link, strike the ceiling spike of the Skyward Strike and restore the sealed quickly. I'm sure Groose would want to do it, I know. You know, he wants to be the hero that saves Zelda. But I think he's too scared right now. Oh, I really liked doing this one. It's like the drawing, bit of drawing. Okay. Like, there wasn't any motion, like, physically drawing, but, like, sort of, like, just swinging in that direction. I always found that fun to do. Now, if Link has to keep doing that every time, then it's going to be a bit of a hassle. You might as well just live here. Hey, Groose. So you wanna be the one to save Zelda? Nice going, Link. Though the imprisoned had only just begun to awaken and break its bonds, I'm impressed you were able to restore the seal, keeping it captive. Unfortunately, you only have succeeded in buying us little more time in which to act. The behemoth you beat back into the confinement is a horror of unspeakable power. Judging by what I saw, I would not be surprised if the seal gave away again soon. So you are left with precious little time to complete the task with which you have been entrusted. Return the sealed temple, Link. There's so much to discuss. With so much precious time. Not only that you're slow, but also with Link's procrastination. It's not good. And I completely miss Groose's somber look. He's like, I totally misjudged Link. As you can see, the gate is nothing more than a slab of cold stone for now. Arousing it from its slumber would require great power. Yes, I believe a shot of holy light from your Skyward sword might just do it. Sorry to disappoint you, boy, but for now your sword lacks the power necessary to awaken the gate. First, you and your sword must grow together. But Fee only talks about my battery life. Brown Woods, Elden Volcano, and Lunaria Desert. The sacred flame is hidden somewhere in each of these lands. Seek them out and purify your soul in their heat. Only after your blade has been tempered by these three fires will be fully imbued with the great power for which you search. Clues for finding the sacred flames have been woven into the lyrics of the song Precious to Your People, the Ballad of the Goddess. These clues are your best hope of finding your way to the flames. Return to Skyloft. Somewhere on the island, there is one whose knowledge of this old song will point you to the right direction. Well, you're not going to tell me who. Maybe Gabe Horonos. Yeah, probably Gabe Horror probably knows stuff like that. Hey, Groose. He's like, huh, I hate even saying this, but I guess you got it all figured out, Granny. Me? Well, there's nothing I can do to help Zelda. I'm useless. Do you know how to get back up? You sell yourself short, my friend. You'll see in time that you have your own role to play in all this. He's probably just going to be playing with the birds, the tiny birds. Link, go now. You trust in fate to guide your feet. Your mission depends on it, as does Zelda's fate. Alright, Fee's got something to say. The Ballad of the Goddess. Based on my projections, this is likely the song Zelda sang on the day of the wing ceremony. I calculate an 85% probability that someone associated with the Academy will be able to provide additional information about the song. What's the 15%? The 15% being Groose? Actually, no, I should have went to the bird statue back there. Oh, I guess I could see where Groose is up to. Oh, come on! I couldn't even do a thing! I'm totally useless! I don't remember this scene. You right, buddy? He's sad. Groose, don't be sad. Ooh. Speaking of sad. Got one bird feather. Okay. I'm pretty sure the blue ones are hard to get. That's why they're different from the other ones. Where did Groose go? He's over here. Ooh, more beetles! Alright, Groose, what's up? I'm just a dead weight. What kind of use is that to anyone? I mean, you'd be good for weightlifting. I don't remember that scene. That little cutscene with Groose getting all upset. Probably because I just went straight into the bird, to that bird statue. There's a blue one. Ha ha! Perfect. If anything, I actually do need like regular bird feathers because I don't even only have one of those. Oh yeah, that's right. I gotta get that the bottle that I got from the chest out of the storage and replace it with the life metal. Well, the life metal is useful. Oh, here we go. A great Goron! I found some. Look, those butterflies that respond to those beautiful tones are swarming all over this place. This has to be the right spot. Oh, this could be a problem. I cannot carry a tune. I could not create beautiful tones if wild animals threaten to roll me down a hill. What could we do? Don't worry, bud. I gotcha. Oh! Oh! Oh no! Link! What did you do? Link, don't look angry. Why you look so angry? The butterfly didn't do anything. I told you to grab the damn harp. Boing. That is it. One of those talking statues the ancient text spoke of. There is just no mistaking it. Oh, I do need that. Are there any more butterflies or did they just run? They're all scared, Link. Look what you did. You killed one of their mates. And now they just don't want to be there. Also, what do you do? Butterflies tend to gather around gossip stones like myself. If you find a spot swarming with butterflies, play a tune of great beauty and the gossip stone might just pop out of the ground with a boing. Ah, okay. Sweet, good to know. Oh, hang on a second. Oh, I do not like look. Okay, I'm just gonna avoid looking at you. I see you looking well these days. If I didn't know better, I'd say you found the time to gather all these variety of magnificent treasures. Come closer. No. Absolutely not. Absolutely not. If I have to stare right into your eyes, I'm rather not. Ooh, there's another... It's starting to get more. That is a sacred shield. 500. I had enough money. I'm sorry, Rupin. I gotta get more money. I had enough money, but I spent it on an adventure pouch. Which, speaking of pouch, you don't come here just to see me, do you? Oh yeah, that's true. Really? Oh, this is a side quest. One of the side quests. Okay, yeah, right. You think I'm gonna fall for that old line? But if they were true, that might be kind of nice. Oh, I almost forgot. I still have a job to do. Do you have something for me to hold? Yeah. I don't want the heart pouch. I want this one. So I can have two bottles. I do have that space. It's all good. What do you have? I do want that sacred shield. It does look pretty nice. But I do not have enough money, so I will come back another time. Don't worry, Reuben. Don't look so disappointed. I've been hearing a weird rumor. Apparently, after nightfall, people have been hearing a woman sobbing in the dormitory. I tell you, it gives me even a big guy like me the creeps. Nighttime, you say? So, it says night... Ooh, granny. These past few days, I swear I hear a voice every time I walk past the restroom at night. Who in the world is in there? I just wish they'd pipe down. Man, they're probably just having a late night constipation. Hey, what's up? Hey, I just checked if Grace's room and the guy's gone. You got any idea where he went? He died. Maybe he had to run away because of his broken heart. Yeah, what a tough guy. That doesn't sound tough to me. Now, where's Link's room? Let's quickly take a nap. Make sure it's nightfall. And see what lie I behold. In the restroom. Alright, it's nighttime. Where is the restroom exactly? Oh, I think it's this one. Oh! Oh no! Somebody please help me. I may be hero of the sky, but I ain't dealing with this. No, I'm joking. I'm joking. I know about this quest already. Oh, paper. Please, somebody bring paper. Bring me some paper. Any kind of paper at all. Paper? I have a map, if you could... Paper? Maybe it's probably like this one. I want to ask the boys if they got some paper. Got some paper? Nah, you don't want you don't have paper, you just want bugs. Colin. Colin's in the other room. Colin's, you got some paper? I'm not afraid of Groose. His room is mine now. That's funny. Colin, get that son of a bitch. He took up not even half, like a third of your room. Third? No, like three quarters of the room. Like, not even three quarters, basically just the rest of the room. Also, where am I gonna find some paper exactly? Alright, do you have paper? You're looking pretty upbeat. You don't have anything else to say. I need someone with paper. Paper for the ghost. I went back to like daytime. I have done this quest, but I've forgotten how to do it. So, I just need to find paper. You have good paper? You've got paper. Hi. Hey Link, what do you think about Pippet? Pippet? Oh, I remember, you have a crush on him. He's nice. Yeah, he's a nice fella. Yes, yes, he is. He's kind and caring, and handsome and wonderful. Oh dear, I don't know what's come over me all of a sudden. Sorry for bothering you with such an awkward question. That's nice. Do you have paper? Oh, can you at least rip some paper here for me? From any of the books? You're just not gonna say anything? Oh, she's got that. She's totally... What do you call that? She's totally smitten for him. Right now, I need some paper. Well, hello. Hello, Colin. Should I give it to her? Should I not give it to her? Oh, Link, it's you. Don't sneak up in me like that. I have a serious dilemma on my mind right now, and you're distracting me. Dilemma? What, you want to hear about it? Normally, I would never, ever tell someone like you, but these are dire times indeed. Come to think of it, you might just be the person I need. You seem to be pretty good with the ladies. Oh yeah, I'm pretty good with Zelda. Ugh, I can't believe I just said that, but whatever, let's do this. Link, I have a task for you. This is super important. So, listen up. Your mission is to take this piece of paper to a certain person. It's a very important piece of paper. Make sure you deliver it. What's your problem? Why are you looking at the restroom? What? There's someone in their restroom at night who wants paper? You fool, how dare you? This is no ordinary piece of paper. It's a letter, a very special one at that. I put my heart in every word. I guess you could say it's sort of like a... Oh, alright, fine. It's a love letter. It's a love letter. Yep, gotta quit bothering me with that. And that is why I will not, and under any circumstances, ever allow it to be used as toilet paper. Do you hear me? So, listen up. The person you must give this to is a girl. A senior student. Her name is Karen. Karen? You know who I mean, right? She's the one with the round hat. She's really cute. You know the one. And don't you dare even by mistake, even thinking of giving it to the weirdo in the restroom. Swear it? Here it is. I'm entrusting this letter to you, so don't read what's inside. Do you hear me? Oh, don't worry, Colin. I know exactly what to do with this letter. Paper. You brought me some paper. I'll open the door. Please come in. But there's no one there. Oh dear, there's a literal hand in there. Alright. Oh, paper. I need paper. I'm not angry or anything. I just need some paper. Don't do it, man. Colin's just like, don't do it. Don't do it! Huh? You're giving me paper? I'm so happy. Feeny? I didn't even realize she had a name. Feeny? Huh. What kind of name is... Feeny? No, I'm pretty sure there'll be a name called Feeny. But this looks like someone's letter. Can I... Are you sure I can have this? Yeah, totally, absolutely. A piece of junk to me. Thank you, I will use it with care. But I'm shy, don't ask me what I want paper for. Maybe we meet again, you kind soul. I'll be honest, I kind of want to end it. I need to end the episode now. But I really want to see how this unfolds. I just found it. I know I've done this quest before. I just find it extremely funny. I'm not going to tell Colin. No, absolutely not. Not like the crap he's been doing with me to these past few years as the Knights Academy. Oh, there's my man, Colin. Hey, Link, did you hand over the letter like I asked? Huh? Are you out of your mind? Seriously, you gave it to that creep in the restroom? Really? You gave it to that restroom weirdo? Don't worry, I just gave him the envelope. Didn't I specifically tell you not to give it to the weirdo in the restroom? Seriously, I said it like 5 times. I know I did. How could you? Anyone who blocks the path of true love deserves to be kicked by a bird. I hate you, Link. Link's just like, yep, not fazed at all. Oh, that's so funny. That is so funny. Ah, where is Karen? Is she still there? Are you right? You don't look fine. Hi. If it isn't Link, you know, you seem to be getting more handsome by the day. That knight's uniforms really suit you and it gives off that reliable vibe. Reliable is a great word, Karen. There's got to be a better name for you. Should I call you Karen? Because I don't like saying Karen. I'm pretty sure you're the one who she likes. You're pretty upbeat. Oh, you just talk about the same thing. No, I don't. See, I don't know why Karen likes you. Actually, while it's daytime, I should be talking to Gaporo about this. Just so plot progresses a bit. Yeah, there he is. You're back, Link. Good to see you're still in one piece. How's it going down there? Are you any closer to finding Zelda? Yes. I see. My dear Zelda, things must be terribly trying for her down there. And it can't be easy for you either, can it? What? You want to know the lyrics of the song Zelda sang on the day of the wing ceremony? You know I'm not much of a singer, just the lyrics. Oh, you just want the lyrics. Oh, what a relief. You put me on the spot there for a moment. I believe the lyrics go something like this. Oh man, I should have made him sing. Oh, you've guided by the servant of the goddess. United earth and sky and bring light to the land. You might as well sing it at this point, Gaporo. That's the first part, but as I recall, there is a second verse to the song too. O youth, show the two whirling sails, the way to the light tower, and before you a path shall open, and a heavenly song you shall hear. I believe that's the whole thing. The light tower mentioned in the song is a real place. I'm sure you've seen it in the tower in the plaza. I don't know a thing of two about whirling sails, though. It sounds like a song is suggesting that if one shows these whirling sails the way to the tower, something will happen. But how do you go about doing that? What does that mean? Two swirling sails. Actually, I should have went to this one and should have went to Gaypor into the next episode, because I'm still doing that side quest with Colin. So, my bad. Because I'm mainly because I'll probably forget, but I think Fee might remind me. Now, I believe I got it one more go to nighttime one more time. Beautiful. Yeah, help. Oh, he's like deep sleep. He just can't sleep. That's what you get. Oh, you're the one from the other day. It's good to see you again. Actually, thanks to you, I met my true love. Yes, him. It started with the letter that you gave me. Those beautiful words of affection caused me to fall hopelessly in love. Ah, oh, my heart is bursting with thoughts of him. I feel so excited, yet so cheerful, so full of life. That's what I'm talking about. Give me those. Ah, my love, I will always be by your side. Oh, poor Colin. Actually, no, not poor Colin. At least Stinch is fine. He didn't care. He just cares about bugs. You're just Groose's sidekick. And you still hate me for that. That's funny. He's gonna be haunted for the rest of his life. And he doesn't even know what. Now. Oh, that's right. We can't get out from the academy at night. So I'm just gonna go morning and then save. And then end the episode right here. This wasn't meant to be a long episode, but I kind of stretched it because of the side quest. Apologize for that, but anyways, it's only like some things happen. Anyways, if you enjoyed this episode, leave a like and possibly subscribe for more of this, of my Let's Plays. And hopefully, on the next episode, well, not hopefully, we definitely will be. On the next episode, we will be going into progressing through what we're currently doing. Trying to find the two whirling spin. Spirals. I'm pretty sure I know what we're doing, but anyways, I will see you into the next one. Bye bye.